some of the best chess games that have ever occurred are dubbed the immortal games. They meant that a certain player tried an idea which was so new and revealing that the whole world had to remember this one game, as though one game became more important than an entire tournament. And one player, his entire life could be expressed in terms of one game.
Nobody has ever played such strong players under clock conditions. He's playing six quite strong players, six serious tournament players, and he's really restricting the amount of time he has, so he's only going to have about 35 minutes per game, which is a huge disadvantage. Plus, he's going to be distracted by playing six games at the same time.
Kasparov is only 24 years old. He was the youngest world champion of all time. He was world champion at age 22. Simply put, the man is a genius.
The chessboard to us is not just 32 pieces or 64 squares. It's the movement of those pieces and the different positions that we see. We can recognize patterns. Whenever I play a game, I make moves, I play positions that nobody has ever played before, and I create ideas that nobody has ever created before, so in that sense, it's very much an art, it's a form of creativity. Psychologically, I'm trying to struggle against myself and also against my opponent, and that also goes on in life, whatever you do, whether it be, you know, sport or business or whatever, you always do, you know, struggles. And so I see chess as sort of a projection, small projection, but a projection of life.
In a given position, I have a plan in this position. Given the plan, we select certain candidate moves that fit in with our plan. And we construct a tree of analysis. If I go here, he can move any of these squares and look at each one by one. So I analyze my candidate moves. At the end, I choose one. But that's really the theory. What a chess player has to fight often is indecisiveness and not trusting himself. Because as you know, chess games are timed. And there really isn't any time for wasted thought.
So, get ready now. Mark is tuned rituals. I've been told that his main problem is with the clock.
A little strong.
I remember playing over one of Kasparov's games a year ago, and my trainer, Boris Kogan, showed the position to me, and he said, okay, black to move and win, can you find it? I spent about 15 minutes, I had no idea. So he showed me the first move, and then he showed me white's reply, and he says, black to move and win, can you find it? And I looked at the position a few minutes. I said, no, I have no idea. So then he showed me the whole combination. It was very nice. But the amazing thing was Kasparov played it when he was 13. And, you know, I was 17, and, you know, I thought I was pretty good for a 17-year-old. And when I saw a highly creative combination like this played by someone, you know, so very young, that's something unexplainable.
No, d4. At last.
Mm-hmm. The field that he's taking on is a very strong field. But Kasparov, in individual matches, has beaten up on everybody that he could find. He's beaten up on the top Western European grandmasters. So now just to play somebody individually is not enough of a challenge. It doesn't mean enough to him now. Now he has to take on groups of people.
Okay, Ilya Gurevich, he's approximately 16. I think he's definitely not so strong when he's pulled out a book. And if he can do that attack, he's the person I think you can crush in the shortest space of time.
He doesn't care about you, though. Yeah, he does worry about his ability. Yeah,
I think I have a good chance of beating him. I hope my style is contradictory to his, my style of playing. That way, I hope I can somehow confuse him and then make him make a mistake.
Queen of eight, king of eight, rook of one, and then mate.
Oh, that is deep.
It's not so deep.
It is.
That's obvious.
It's deep.
Marvelous.
Tonight, the best chances seem to lie with Patrick Wolfe, since he's the strongest of all of us six. And he's had more experience than any one of us. He's played in stronger tournaments than any one of us, and he's beaten stronger opponents than I think all of us combined.
This is Patrick with black.
Okay. Strong player.
He's a very strong player, strong position. He's.
I mean, castles, take.
Gotta be relatively equal.
White undoubtedly is a sled.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
Okay, now I play this one.
Okay, I'll tell you what we have on him. I don't know very much about him. He's very solid, very imaginative.
If I play e6, you don't take, of course, because I play check.
Okay.
But you do this move.
He looks for very deep plans.
Mm-hmm.
But he's also willing to change the plan if he sees that it's not working.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He's the most dangerous opponent.
I don't think anybody except Kasparov would attempt to do this kind of thing, because it's nobody likes to lose in chess, especially very good players, and it's very hard to play six games at the same time. So it's almost impossible.
Tonight, it doesn't matter that I win. It doesn't matter if I draw. It doesn't matter if I lose. I hope to engage in one of these brilliant games. If I lose and it's because of a beautiful attack, then wonderful, then I'm part of something. And if I draw, then equally good. And if I win, well, that'd be excellent as well.
I'm just gonna try to make the best moves. Because in chess, if you make the best moves, you won't lose, right?
It's very exciting, of course. The pressure's off you because the worst that can happen is you can lose to a world champion.
Are you thinking about the possibility of being able to beat Garry Kasparov tonight?
I'll try my best. I'm lucky enough to have the white pieces, which is the slight advantage.
Find the best possibility. I like to analyze positions.
Start at the spot. I'm trying to date with Mr. Kasparov in 24 minutes. This may break up Perestroika if I start his clock.
Perestroika.
Don't take Russian.
Neither do I.
I pronounce it like Dan Rather, okay?
We thought about it for a long time, and we decided we'd get Toblerone because it's Swiss chocolate, and that we thought would be neutral.
There are chocolates. You can have any of them except for the Toblerone, okay?
Okay.
You can have all the chocolates except for the Toblerone. If there's anything you need, like food or special...
Chocolates?
You can have the chocolates except for the Toblerone, okay?
He's the world champion, and he's got to defend himself, and he's got to defend himself. And I'm going to do everything I can to beat him.
Are you nervous?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The world chess champion, Garry Kasparov.
Just before the match begins, we would like to ask everybody's cooperation. In order to play chess at this level, the players are going to be concentrating very intensely.